Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidil Anbiya ibn Mursaleen wa ala alihi wa sahabihi ajma'in. As-salatu wa salamu alayka ya Rasulullah wa ala alika wa sahabika ya Habiballah. As-salatu wa salamu alayka ya Nabiyallah wa ala alika wa sahabika ya Nurallah sallallahu ta'ala alayka wa sallam. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Welcome to the second episode on how to spend Ramadan Mubarak. And as it was mentioned in first episode, we are going through the book which is compiled by Amir Sunni Dawate Islami, how to spend Ramadan Mubarak. And inshallah, as days they go on, we will be going through different chapters. Last week we started with few different topics which are there in this book. First is, there was analysis of the name, why it was named Ramadan, or what can be the reason why this month was named Ramadan. And then our pious predecessors doing the analysis of the words, letters which are there in the word Ramadan. And then we went through few of the excellences or significance of the month of Ramadan over other months. And inshallah, I will carry on from where we stopped. And from what I can remember, we discussed that if you do any nafil action, any voluntary worship in the month of Ramadan, you are rewarded as if you do something fard. And if you do something fard, alhamdulillah, the reward is multiplied 70 times. The next, and then we did that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He pays special attention towards His slaves in this month. Again, important fazilat of this month is, or the significance of this month to the other months is being said, the doors of paradise are opened in this month, and the doors of hell are closed. So alhamdulillah, the doors of Jannah are opened and the doors of Jahannam are closed in this month. And this is from the hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in which Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he says that when the month of Ramadan arrives, the doors of paradise are opened. So this is again the sign of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that especially in the month of Ramadan, the doors of hell are closed. And that is the reason our scholars, they say, if anyone who passes away in the month of Ramadan, we have hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that person will enter into Jannah. And then again, one of the excellence which is being mentioned about this month is that the doors of skies, the heavens, are opened, and the supplication of the servants are easily able to reach the doors of acceptance. Allahu Akbar. So this is again one of the ways mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us to make dua. And when we are hungry, when we are thirsty, when we are abstaining from things that needs to be abstained from in the month of Ramadan, if we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept the doors of heavens open so that they can reach to the door of acceptance. And as it was mentioned earlier, that Quran was revealed in this month. So it's not only Quran, or it wasn't only the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that was sent to this dunya. Except for Quran, there are other major books or other famous books, they were sent to different prophets. And not only that, there were some pages, some booklets, they were sent to other prophets as well. They were sahifas. And it's been mentioned that it was in the month of Ramadan, these sahifas were revealed to Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, and it was first of this month. The Old Testament, Torah, which was revealed to Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, it was revealed on the 6th of this month. Bible, Injil, that was revealed on 13th of this month, and Quran was revealed in this month. So alhamdulillah, you know, all these books which are heavenly books, they are the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quite few of them mentioned here, they were revealed in the month of Ramadan. Now another significance which is there with the month of Ramadan, that there are many important incidents and there are many blessed personalities, they passed away in the month of Ramadan. And amongst those personalities, that passed away in the month of Ramadan. First one is the beloved daughter of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha. She passed away on 3rd of this month. Likewise, our blessed mother, Hazrat Khadijat al-Kubra radiallahu ta'ala anha, even she passed away in the month of Ramadan. And again, Ummul Mumineen, Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she passed away on the 17th of this month. And then the lion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazrat Ali, karamallahu ta'ala wajhul kareem, he passed away on the 21st of the month of Ramadan. You know, these are the personalities, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them with Ramadan to pass away from this dunya. So this was about the personalities, and inshallah in coming days, you know, we will be talking about these personalities, the day when they departed from this world, you know, in little bit more detail. And what were the important incidents or important events that took place? So the first battle of Islam, the battle of Badr, took place on 17th of this month. And another important event was, you know, our Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he was born in Makkah al-Mukarramah. But Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he had to leave Makkah al-Mukarramah and migrate to Madinah al-Munawwara. And it was one of the difficult things for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to do. But alhamdulillah, it was in the month of Ramadan, Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he was victorious over Makkah al-Mukarramah. The conquest of Makkah al-Mukarramah, it happened on the 20th of the month of Ramadan. So these were a few significance or the excellences of the month of Ramadan over other months. And this is just to make you mentally prepared for it. The month which is coming, don't take it lightly. This is the month which has got blessings in it. This is the month which has got immense reward in it. This is the month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pays special attention to his servants. So this is the month to gain from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's prepare ourselves mentally for this month. One more hadith and then inshallah we will finish this session. This hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in which Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he says, every evening at the time of iftar, you know, we all know how the time of iftar is for us. Everyone is focused, everyone is preparing for iftar, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he rewards his servants at that time. And what is that reward? It's been said, every evening at the time of iftar in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he frees 100,000 such people from the fire of hell, upon whom the fire of hell or Jahannam was compulsory, was wajib. And on the final night of Ramadan, the number of people freed is the same as the number that have been freed in all the previous nights of Ramadan combined together. Subhanallah. So every day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he frees 100,000, not one, not two, not three, 100,000 people from the fire of hell. And who are these people? These are the people on whom Jahannam is wajib. And when we say Jahannam is wajib, that means they were to be going to Jahannam, or it was going to be like that, they will be going to Jahannam. But because of the blessing of the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees them from the fire of hell. So you need to be very careful. Many a times our brothers, our sisters, they spend that time just, you know, preparing for iftar. Just don't do it until Maghrib time. You know, plan yourself and prepare your iftar maybe at least 10-15 minutes before the time for iftar comes, okay, before Maghrib times, and give little bit of time in making dua. Dua is the way to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and especially at the time of iftar, when you're finishing your fast, you feel like you've done something and you're sincere in your duas. You try to put yourself in dua. And this is the time to ask for mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the light of this hadith, there can't be anything better than asking freedom from the fire of hell when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving it to many people, especially on whom Jahannam is wajib. So I will request all our brothers and sisters, especially time before iftar, dedicate it for dua. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he says that it's not just restricted up to, you know, these 100,000 people daily. Is being mentioned when it comes to the last night of Ramadan, when it comes to the last or the final night of Ramadan, the number of people freed is the total of total number of people they've been freed for the whole month of Ramadan combined. I will leave it for you to calculate. But my dua is, and you also make dua, maybe we are included in those people who are freed from the fire of hell in this blessed month. So I hope, inshallah, Lazim, our brothers and sisters who are listening to me, they will get themselves prepared for the month of Ramadan. Not only preparation in terms of getting things at home so that we have got provisions for iftar, for sahri, but to prepare ourselves in a way to reap benefit, to gain benefit from this blessed month which is coming to us, to take us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and can be means for our forgiveness and can be means to make our place in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq to act on whatever has been said. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
SDI चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल बटन पर क्लिक करें ताकि आपको सबसे पहले हमारी नए वीडियोस और लाइव इज्तिमा के लिंक मिले।